Finally, to the NBI, are you currently conducting investigations on the allegations made by Mrs. Bautista?
Yes, Your Honor. We've already coordinated with several government agencies with respect to the investigation, and particularly with the involving the accounts with the Luzon Development Bank. And as an update to that, we also discovered that sequestered companies or surrendered companies under PCGG maintained accounts with the Luzon Development Bank.
Oh, so PCGG itself?
No, Your Honor. Sequestered and surrendered companies of managed by PCGG maintained accounts with Luzon Development Bank.
And you're investigating this also?
Yes, Your Honor. We actually made coordination with the BSP with respect to the financial statements of LDB and study and make analysis on the deposit liabilities increases thereof, because we noted something that could be considered red flag on that.
Thank you.
On that point, ma'am, sorry, that's an insinuation I would like to clarify in fairness to LDB. Sequestered companies have accounts with LDB. The only relation that may have would be because the Chairman Bautista used to be chair of PCGG. Is that the reason why you, sorry, it was a bit off for me?
Yes, because we have to make a financial analysis on a historical basis. Because he entered the government in year 2010, and then we have to review the transactions particular to that. And because of the bank accounts, the sequential numbers of the bank accounts with respect to Luzon Development Bank, we made an analysis that it is in sequence, and we tried to find out what entities also possibly deposited on that particular period. And we were able to discover that sequestered companies also deposited at Luzon Development Bank.
During the incumbency of Chairman Bautista as PCGG chair?
Yes, Your Honor.
In other words, bago nun nasa ibang banko o walang account dati?
Previously, it was in another bank.
And then during his term, it was transferred to LDB?
Yes.
Up to now, it's still there?
No, it was already closed sometime in 2016.
Presumably, nilipat din sa ibang banko dahil bago na yung PCGG chair?
We will still have to verify.
Perhaps that's one thing we should look into as well, Senator Soto, because it's common practice too. Pag bago yung mayor, nililipat yung depository bank. Pag bago yung chairman, nililipat yung depository bank. I mean, at the end of the day, it should be in the interest of government to put it in one, usually a government bank. Instead of giving any chair of any GOCC or any agency the leeway to decide which bank to deposit the monies of that GOCC or sequestered company may be to a bank of their choice. You may proceed, Senator Soto.
All right, thank you. So, I understand that you are in possession, of course, of the affidavit of Mrs. Bautista. No?
Yes.
Together with its attachments?
Yes, Your Honor.
Are there copies of the bank book or passbooks attached in the affidavit of Luzon Development Bank?
There are documents attached to it, Your Honor.
Can you provide the committee copies?
Your Honor, because of the confidential nature, and we are considering the possibility of violating the bank secrecy law with respect to the bank deposits. Thus, we are in no position to, until we have come out with a report that we divulge these documents, Your Honor.
With the permission of Senator Soto, ma'am, confidentiality of the pieces of evidence submitted to you?
Sorry?
I understand media personalities who interviewed both Chairman Bautista and Tisha Bautista took photos of the documents they have, and they still have it in their phones. In fact, it is also shown on TV by both parties. So, what would be the basis of the confidentiality that you are citing?
Because there are transactions involved, Your Honor, with respect to the bank accounts, and it is going into the details already, and thus the investigation should not be hampered on that, Your Honor.
No, just to clarify. If you're saying your investigation may be hampered if these documents will be made public, that's an entirely different issue. But you're not citing the secrecy of bank deposits law as a basis for you not to submit it to us.
Yes, Your Honor, with respect to the details of these bank accounts.
NBI. May I ask the BSP or even AMLOC
to submit the documents?
I will go to Attorney Lim later, but he might be a biased source, although he's also a lawyer. Is the NBI or any other private person covered by the bank secrecy law?
Yeah, all who violates the bank secrecy law.
No. They happen to have it legally because it was submitted to them, although there's a case for robbery or whatever, but as of now, it's legal. And they're looking at those bank accounts right now. So are you saying even the wife of Chairman Bautista violated the bank secrecy law? I think it only applies to the bank if ever. Should it apply to any person who happens to see it? So if the media person took a picture of it, and these are joint accounts, huh? And according to Attorney Lim, it needs the waiver of the other co-depositors as well. Then Chairman Bautista violated the bank secrecy law too by revealing the accounts of his co-depositors to other people and vice versa. I don't think it should be stretched that much.
Mr. Chairman, if you read the bank secrecy law, if I recall it correctly, the prohibition is on the officials and employees of the depository bank.
Exactly.
Of the depository bank. And if I recall, that's what the bank secrecy law provides. Now, this is a peculiar case because the bank accounts were revealed by someone who is not even an account holder. If I recall correctly, the bank interviews. In other words, Mrs. Bautista, if I recall correctly, is not an account holder.